took me to task and said, no, man, I am just confident. I'm confident because I beat the likes of Rey Mysterio. I beat the Chris Jerichos. I beat the Benoits. He says he's beaten them all, but he's usually got an open contract, willing to take on anybody that's going to get in the ring against him.
Well, that arrogance certainly came through the last couple of Mondays on Nitro when Eddie Guerrero came out to the announce set and joined us for his color commentary. A matchup this past Monday involving Dean Malenko, and he certainly didn't have kind words for Malenko. That long-term respect that these two rivals had always had for each other seems to have taken a back seat now that Guerrero is wearing the championship gold.
Eddie Guerrero would like to think that that championship gold belongs to him, that it's his own personal property. He wants to construct a mantle on which to put it permanently. He'd like nothing more than to engrave his name on it as opposed to WCW. And I will say this, thus far he's really been a spectacular champion, a fighting champion.
Oh, Lenny Lane on the offensive in the early going. Flips up and over the top rope and crashes into young Mike Tolbert. To my knowledge, making his WCW debut, at least here on our main event exclusives, and now tosses Tolbert back into the ring.
Your reward for doing well on TBS here on the main event is that you're going to get a shot at a Mysterio or a Chris Benoit or a Jericho or a Malenko. Kind of the good news, bad news. Hey, you won, but guess what? You get Malenko. Oh, well, maybe I better rethink this position here.
Nice counter by the young man, Tolbert. The double leg power bomb now drives a right hand to the side ahead of Lenny Lane and shoots him off into the ropes where he meets him with a lariat.
Down for the cover. One, two, hooking him up. Nice move by Tolbert. Almost got him for the three count. Did the right thing, Iron Mike.
Well, very close to what I think we both would have to term an upset that time. Mike Tolbert just a split second away from a win.
I know young wrestlers watching, it's always good to see when another young wrestler does something so well, not only go vertical for the pin, but to hook the opponent up by the leg, try to cinch him up, give him nowhere to run, and go for the 1-2-3.
Lee, I know it's starting to sound like a broken record, but how about the capacity crowd this past Monday in Buffalo at the Marine Midland Arena for Nitro, and we certainly expect another sellout crowd this Monday when we head to Charlotte, North Carolina in the Queen City.
We're going to Carolina in my mind, to quote James Taylor, and I think everybody in and around the Queen City of Charlotte remembers one of the last times we were there, the line snaking around the building. I've mentioned that old R&B tune, Little Anthony and the Imperials. Do not be on the outside looking in on this one. There are a few tickets left in Charlotte. Our recommendation is go out and get one while you can and join us for Monday Nitro.
And if there's ever a city that I want to see Scott Hall take his survey in,
yeah.
You talk about WCW country, Ric Flair's hometown, take your survey this Monday in Charlotte, Scott Hall. There's a challenge to you.
Well, you know he's going to. We talk about arrogance and cockiness. I mean, Scott Hall really exemplifies that. He's going to do the survey in Charlotte. I don't think he's much going to like the result, but he'll do it.
Nice reversal by Lenny Lane. Sends him into the corner and bulldogs him in the center of the ring.
Good heads-up move by Lenny Lane going for the pin. Hooks him up the 1-2 and the 3. Nice win by Lenny Lane. You talk about climbing the ladder. That's one more rung for this young man.